This ASAP Sports Performance video is brought to you by the Kellogg Hotel and Conference Center, located on the campus of Michigan State University. It's East Lansing, Michigan's four-star hotel experience. This ASAP Performance video is also brought to you by the Ram Sled Company, makers of strength training and conditioning products for football and other athletic endeavors. Get the equipment used by collegiate and professional teams at www.theramsled.com. This is Coach Ed Sicali with another ASAP Athletic Strength and Power Sports Performance video. We caught up with Michigan State University's head strength coach, Ken Mannie, a candid, high-energy, and demonstrative veteran in the strength and conditioning field. Coach Mannie has been training athletes for over 30 years, 16 with the Spartans of Michigan State, and has worked with championship coaches like Nick Saban and Mark D'Antonio.
Nice avowal on you, son.
We discussed a variety of topics, including today's on training the neck.
Oh, yeah, the emphasis that we place on the neck goes back, obviously, to Dan Riley, when, as a high school coach, we would attend the Penn State Clinic. And this goes back, this is back in the, mid-70s or so. And Dan would always start all of his presentations out with a thorough neck training sequence, whether it was manual neck work, whether it was on the machines, whether it was shrugs, no matter what it was, but he always made sure that he started out stressing the importance of the neck region. And that's stuck with me forever. And so any time we start a workout, you saw us out there today, being primary an upper body emphasis, we're going to do some manual neck, at least flex and extension. They can get their lateral flexions on the machine. We didn't do much in the way of shrug work today, but that we make sure at least once a week we do some good shrug work. And but the neck is done around here a minimum of twice per week, and that's forward flexion, back extension, side or lateral flexions, shrug work. And we had a young man unfortunately had a fracture of the cervical vertebrae 1998 against Oregon. Amp Campbell's his name, and thank God it did not sever his spinal cord, but that was our opening game that year. And he missed the rest of the season, obviously, and there was a question as to whether he would come back or not. But through a lot of rehab, being in a halo for many months, and just going to a lot of people, a lot of NFL cervical physicians, those that specialize in the cervical spine area, it was determined that Amp could play again with good training, which he did. He came back, and as a matter of fact, it was in the Oregon game when he had the accident. And then he comes back the next year against Oregon and scores a winning touchdown. So that was kind of a nice story and inspirational story. But he had poor technique on the tackle. It was more of a technique thing than anything. And had the head down, had the cervical spine on a column, which you don't want. Had that axial loading, top of the head. His top of the head hit the thigh pad of the Oregon runner. And, bad things happened from there. Thank God it was not catastrophic in nature, but it opens people's eyes. It does.